Hey guys, Hubs here. Welcome to my Clash of Clans gold guide on how to make over 1 million gold an hour. Now, this is a time-sensitive thing. As you know, recently, Clash of Clans just said quicker barbarians and dragons times 5. Now, they didn't give us a deadline. They said limited time. It could be gone tomorrow, it could be gone the next day. So, this is important because you know what? I don't believe it takes somebody that's uber. I'm level Town Hall 8. My barbarians are level 5, my dragons are level 3, which is pretty awesome for Town Hall 8. Now you're thinking, okay, what's an awesome combination between barbarians and dragons? I tried many, many hours of both, and I finally narrowed it down. I tried just barbarians, and you're thinking, just barbarians? Just barbarian sucks. Everybody knows barching. Now, when I do barch, I usually make over 2 million gold an hour. I do, but I normally have to pay some gems to boost my barracks, and maybe I boost my potions, and I boost my king. This is no boosting whatsoever, just using the 5 times. Now, the key to this is you do want to make sure that you're in between your trophy range at about 1,000 to about 1,399. Right in that range is good. You go a little bit over, it's good to drop. Now, let's say your barbarians aren't level 5. Then it's okay to drop down a little bit as well. What you're gonna see in the background is my hour. Now, I figured it out that on average, you're gonna get an attack in every 3 minutes. So you wanna go for an average, that's about 20 attacks an hour. You wanna get an average of about 60 gold, 60,000 gold, not 60 gold. 60 gold, you won't have much by the end of it. So how do you do that? Yes, there are some inactive players who have that lovely elixir and gold mine just filled to the brim on the outskirts. You'll find some of those, but you'll find some that you're actually going to have to, you know, break in. You want to get those walls down, you know, hammer the AoE first, go after the wizards, go after the mortars. Once those are out of the way, you should be able to clear everything out. And you'll see a few fails along the footage, so it's not always, it's not 100% success ratio on every attack. But some attacks, I get more than 60k, some less, and in the end, it ended up being 1.2 million. I could easily just switch my focus to Elixir and, you know, pass on the high gold ones. But typically, if I see something that, you know, is easy grabbins, I might as well take the extra Elixir. Elixir right now, for me, considering I'm building my town hall, there's only one thing I have to upgrade. Unfortunately, it's my barracks. I don't want to hit that right now because I'm making gold. I'm getting ready to spend a ton. I stream all this live at twitch.tv/wowhubs. If any of you guys watch it live, do a ton of battles, do a ton of strategy. I do some base reviews, everything else. Links in the description below. Now moving on to some other strategies. Some things really, really suck if the person you're attacking has any air defense. Well, if you just have barbarians, are really useless. So if you do ask your guild for anything, ask for air. And a little hint, if you're in this trophy range, or even about 1,000 below the 1,100, because if the people have barbarians level 4, they're probably going to go after that and still get some really hefty loot. I would ask for defense air. After seeing how powerful this is, and I know that even through my clan, everybody's talking about it because I mentioned it through my clan, and this is why I'm putting it out now, guys, and urgent, because I wanted to make sure that you guys, if you are in a clan, you can let your friends know, hey, there's a gold guide out there. That way it will help you guys out in your wars, help you build your walls, help you build your defenses, and you don't have to spend any gems whatsoever, which is fantastic. Now, what about that strategy I used to do 2 million gold an hour? Well, I do cover that on live, but I will bring out a video on it after this event is over. But right now I'm going to say, you know what, I'm saving my gems. I'm just going to barbarian up, get it done for free, hammer through these guys, and you know, why not save the gems for when I need them. There's a few fights where the barbarians aren't going to go the right way. A couple other little tips I learned in the hours and hours of me farming and testing all this out was to pull the barbarians back, because sometimes if you place your where you drop them back, they'll actually go more towards a wall rather than towards the side closest target, and then they're getting hit by the actual wizards. But if you pull it back, it will go right to the wall by the wizard or right by the mortar and get it down quick. You'll be tempted to make wall breakers, but you know what? It just slows down the process. Yes, it would make it more efficient because you get them in quicker. And yes, when I do my 2 million gold an hour, yes, I do use wall breakers. Yes, I use archers. But then I normally gem because I'm sitting down for a 2-hour session, making the most of my time that I've invested into it. Now, another quick tip is make sure that you've got your barracks producing these barbarians while you're fighting, because there was the odd time where, you know, all of a sudden you went back and they weren't all ready for you, or you had to remake them from scratch. And that's a few minutes, which equals probably on average 60,000 gold, which, you know what? We've all had fights where we got 400,000 gold or 200,000 gold and you're thinking 60K, but remember, this is about speed and efficiency. Also, one other thing is if you can do a battle and you don't need to use them all, don't use them all, because the moment that you finish up, you'll be ready to go right again. So sure, you might only get 20 or 30, but the moment you're done, bam, you're back in. You might get another 20 or 30 or a 50 or a hundo, who knows? There's going to be a lot of bases too that you're going to pass by that have a lot of gold, that have X-wing, X-bows, and you're going to end up saying, oh, look at that, 300,000, and don't go for it. Unless, you know, that's close to the edge, maybe you have a potion. I only spent a few potions within this hour, and I only used my Barbarian King when I absolutely needed them, because I didn't want to get it to get, you know, an extra 20k. You'll see the last battle of the day was my best battle. I used a potion, used a Barbarian King, and topped it up over 4 million. Now, what do I need with 4 million gold? Everything is maxed at the moment, except for my walls. And you know what? Nothing like upgrading some fresh walls. Guys, this is an ongoing series. If you enjoyed it, hit the subscribe button. I'll have more Clash of Clans out. I do base reviews, like I said. Some of them I put on YouTube. Some of them I do at twitch.tv/WoWHobbs. And I post everything on my Twitter. That way you'll be notified on the go. And, you know, I post some other things too. I do focus on this game a lot and two other games. If you're into Hearthstone or World of Warcraft, I've got all the playlists in the link below, guys. And lastly, as long as you guys keep watching, I'll keep making them. Thanks again. Till next time.